place on the World Championship podium, isn't it, for Marcus Yell. And that would be an extreme effort, his previous best, that ninth position finish in the 2021 World Championship.
Another rider to watch. He can never write off, despite his advancing year. Stefan Svensson, as we have seen, not just yesterday, but on Friday at the Legends event as well. He really is a true legend of ice racing in every respect.
What a brilliant story. Stefan Svensson coming out of retirement for 2023 to celebrate his 40th season in the sport. Remember, he quit the national team at the end of 2017, so stopped racing in the what is now the Ice Speedway of Nations. Stepped down from the World Championship at the end of 2019, and that queued up the first comeback for what was supposed to be a single season in 2020, just to provide some cover as a result of the global pandemic. But I was chatting to him yesterday about our conversation at Heerenveen last April. He really still had the glint in his eye at that stage, and everyone, including myself, was asking him whether he had maybe another season in him, and he did almost map the first out onto track. Is Luca Bauer, who goes in the red helmet colour for this one, heat number one. And Bauer, who made his World Championship debut at this venue back in 2016. He was then aged just 17. He's 25 years of age now and already prepared to inherit his father's legacy.
Riders coming through the tapes then for heats number one. Luca Bauer goes off the inside gate in red. Gate two in blue, it is Franz Meyerbuchler, his fellow German. Gate three for the Czech Republic is Andrei Divish and Benedikt Mon. Replacement for Hans Faber off the outside in yellow. Alexander Latozinski of Ukraine is your referee. The red fries. Time to go racing here on day two at INZELL. They're away at a super start by Luca Bauer. Leads the way into the first turn. It's a rider in white who has got out in second, Andrei Divish. Bauer clears off down the back straight as expected. Third place in blue, it is Franz Meyerbuchler, looking to make up for a disappointing day yesterday. A trademark rather slow start for Benedikt Mon. He's trying to catch up from the back, but he can certainly overtake. He's going for the outside coming off turn two. Has a look at his fellow countryman, Franz Meyerbuchler. Andrei Divish going well up there in second. Bauer's away and gone in the lead. Here comes Mon around the outside, and he's through into third place.
Yes, momentary bobble going into the top then from Franz Meyerbuchler. That was enough for Mon to find his way through, and he might be about to take another place as well.
Yes, he's closing on Andrei Divish, the Czech Republic international. Mon having a look on the outside. It's all the battle for second place at the moment. Luca Bauer is away and gone as they go into the final lap. Divish holding second place. Let's see what Benedikt Mon can do. He went into the safety barrier in his second ride yesterday coming off turn two. He avoids it this time. Luca Bauer is coming in for a clear win. Here comes Benedikt Mon with the last bend lunge. He's going through and he snatches second place on the final turn. Andrei Divish third, Franz Meyerbuchler at the back.
Yes, entertaining ride that from Benedikt Mon, from fourth and through for second. Franz Meyerbuchler holding him back for quite a while. Good defensive ride early on, but eventually it comes to naught quite literally, and Mon is then able to find his way through on Andrei Divish as well. So I did say that we would see him make more of an impression getting a full meeting here this afternoon, and Benedikt Mon has proved it in the opening race of the day. Straightforward stuff though for Luca Bauer.
Yes, indeed. Luca Bauer, 3 points to open his meeting then for the win. Benedikt Mon, a fine ride around the outside line to come through into second place. 1 point for Andrei Divish the third, and more bad luck for Franz Meyerbuchler. A weekend of struggle for him.
Now moving on then with heat number two, as Martin Hara-Hiltunen makes his first appearance of the meeting. He goes here in the blue helmet colour. And Swede now a three times final winner. What a remarkable story he's had in the sport. Made his debut midway through 2015, made his first grand final against the Russians in his debut World Championship season in 2018. Suffered an elbow fracture at the 2020 European Championship. That caused him to miss 2021 as a whole through injury. He had the plate removed in that elbow in November of 2021. Went on to win the 2022 World title. He is your reigning champion and points leader.
He goes off gate number two in blue here. It's Jo Seitra of Norway off gate one in red. Lukas Hutler of the Czech Republic. Slightly disappointing day for him yesterday, only picking up 5 World Championship points. And Marcus Yell, the German champion, could be the main challenger to Hara-Hiltunen here. He goes off gate number four in yellow. An impressive day for him yesterday. So Seitra, Hara-Hiltunen, Hutler and Yell for heat number two here on day two at INZELL. And it is, as expected, Martin Hara-Hiltunen who makes a perfect start. Leads the way into the first turn. Yell around the outside of Hutler on the first turn and up into second place. A slower getaway for Jo Seitra. He is at the back. But going after Martin Harri-Hiltunen, it is Marcus Jell, but no stopping the Swedes so far. He's in perfect out in front once again.
Yes, Harri-Hiltunen, who favoured that gate two position yesterday, ultimately had three races from it, two during the heats, and then picking it for the grand final, and he's using it to good effect once again here this afternoon. The squabble was always likely to be for second position in this one, and just coming off turn two down the back straight, rider in the white helmet colour, Lucas Hutler, looked like he had absolutely no speed, and Marcus Jell pulling well clear for a damage limitation ride in second place. But as you said, no stopping Harri-Hiltunen, the opening two races of the day going as per the form book.
Yes, disappointment once again for Hutler back in third place behind Marcus Jell. Jo Seitra is at the back, but Martin Harri-Hiltunen is going to make it seven wins out of seven for the weekend. He takes the flag. Second place will go to Marcus Jell. It's Hutler comes over in third. No points for Jo Seitra in fourth.
And Setro had a decent final one here in Insult. Doesn't get off to the best of starts in final two, but Marcus Jell doing his bit, and Lucas Hutler at least getting among the scorers in his opening outing. But this is the problem you're faced with if you're the likes of Marcus Jell, just outside of those top four positions yesterday. To try and keep up with the likes of Martin Harri-Hiltunen, and a real struggle. He had so much speed out in front and won it by a clear margin.
So Martin Harri-Hiltunen picks up his seventh race victory of the weekend, another 3 points in the book. Marcus Jell in second for 2 points, 11 world championship points for him yesterday. Lucas Hutler, just the 1 point. He's got to claim some scalps over the rest of the meeting for a decent result. No points for Jo Seitra.
On now to heat number three, and an important matchup here between Harald Simon and Stefan Svensson. And these were the two men, remember, who battled it out for fourth place yesterday. Ultimately, on reflection, it was their heat one matchup that settled it. Simon beat Svensson there. Svensson finished qualifying on 11 heat points, Simon on 12. So an important race here right from the start between Harald Simon and Stefan Svensson.
Simon will be off gate one in red, the 2022 European champion. Gate two in blue, it is Stefan Svensson, ice speedway legend. Jimmy Olsen, another Swede, off gate number three in white. He picked up 8 world championship points yesterday, and the youngest man in the field, 16-year-old Sebastian Reitsma of the Netherlands, goes off gate number four. No points for him yesterday, and he will be desperate to improve here today. The start marshal has them into line for heat number three. Simon, Svensson, Olsen and Reitsma takes up, and away they go. A bit of a slow start for Jimmy Olsen. It's Svensson making a decent start round the outside of Simmons. We saw these two riders have an entertaining matchup yesterday, and it's Svensson who has gone to the front. Harald Simon in second place. He'll be desperate to get through here and get as many points on the board as he aims for a world championship podium this year. Jimmy Olsen has come through into third place ahead of Sebastian Reitsma. He's going for the outside, but it's all about these two out in front, as Simon puts Stefan Svensson under pressure, trying to have a look to the inside as they come through turns three and four. There's going to be contact there. That was very close. I thought Stefan Svensson was heading for the straw bales. He's just about saved it, and Stefan Svensson still in the lead, and here comes Jimmy Olsen up on the outside as well. Terrific race here, the best day so far.
Here comes Olsen then for the big lunge around the outside on lap number three, but it's side by side at the front, and Simon this time knows it's clear.
Yes, Harald Simon up the inside. He saw the gap there coming out of turn four. Here comes Olsen's going to try and go around the outside of both of them. A terrific race between these three. Simon leads into the back straight. Svensson fighting back on the outside. Is Stefan Svensson going to come through? It looks like he is. Simon back at the inside. He cuts into the lead, and he's done it. Oh, brilliant. Harald Simon wins it. Stefan Svensson second. Jimmy Olsen third. That's the race of the weekend so far.
My goodness me. Aggressive stuff there throughout from Harald Simon. He was very forceful on Stefan Svensson. Svensson, such a fair racer, always leaves a bit of room. There was no room being left there by Harald Simon. Svensson doing so well to come back at the Austrian in the latter stages to recover that race lead. Simon was having none of it. It was always set to be the most important race of this opening block, and Harald Simon, by taking it, has already taken a psychological advantage over his main rival for a place in the grand final yesterday, Stefan Svensson.
How important could that race win be in the final reckoning for Harald Simon? That could go some way to getting him into the grand final. Stefan Svensson will be frustrated there. A couple of lucky escapes in there. Jimmy Olsen wasn't far behind either. Sebastian Reitsma, the Dutchman at the back.
Now moving on then to heat number four, and this one an important race, you'd suggest, for Nicholas Svensson, who was disappointing yesterday, had a tough first ride on the programme here as well. 32-year-old, really on good form coming into this weekend. We said it yesterday, second in the Nordic final behind Martin Harahiltunen. He was fourth in the Swedish Championship, but only seventh yesterday. So he'll be keen to start strong in this one to underline his credentials after 2 years out of the World Championship.
Nicholas Svensson off gate number one in red. Gate two is the Finnish champion, Mats Järf, in blue. Gate three in white, his fellow countryman, Max Koivula, the younger of the Finns. And it's Frankie Zorn, the European champion, from the outside in yellow. The riders in red and yellow should be the two to watch here. Zorn will start as the favourite from gate four. The revs begin to rise then. Svensson, Järf, Koivula and Zorn underway. A decent start by Nicholas Svensson from the inside, but it is Frankie Zorn who hits the first turn first. They're all close, bunched up out of turn two. Nicholas Svensson having a look. The two Finns are side by side for third place. Järf moves through on the inside ahead of Max Koivula. And the inside goes Nicholas Svensson, has a look there as Zorn ran a bit wide out of turn four. Here he comes again on that tighter line. He's going through on the inside. A surprise here in heat number four. Zorn trying to fight back, but it's Nicholas Svensson who's gone to the front. He's gone too quickly into turn three, hits a bump, just about holds onto it. Frankie Zorn is fighting back at the inside, has a look into turn one. He's going to go underneath Nicholas Svensson, goes through, and the European champion retakes the lead.
Well, at least he was made to work for it. That's much more like it from Nicholas Svensson, who didn't look to have any fight in final one. He certainly had more in just his opening ride than he did throughout the afternoon and evening yesterday, and he's coming back for more on the final lap.
He certainly is, yes. Svensson's not giving up. He's chasing hard after fast Frankie Zorn. He's going to go for the outside into the final turn. Nicholas Svensson's going for broke on the wider line. Is he going to do it? Not quite. Frankie Zorn takes the win. Second for Svensson. Mats Järf comes over in third. Max Koivula at the back.
Mats Järf getting through on Max Koivula, made a stinker of a start that comes through for the consolation point, and after an excellent start to his meeting in final number one, it was always going to be tough for him to live with the likes of Nicholas Svensson and Frans Zorn. But what a race we had up at the head of the field, the pair of them switching and changing lines, and Svensson trying his darndest to get through on Zorn, holds the race lead in the early stages, but Zorn eventually will not be denied.
Well, Nicholas Svensson will be frustrated there. He was determined to get ahead of fast Frankie Zorn. Some brilliant racing we've seen so far today in INZELL. 3 points for Zorn, two for Svensson. Mats Järf gets 1 point for third, but no points for Max Koivula, whose format seems to be making quick starts but then dropping back in his races this weekend. But the Finn has plenty of years ahead of him, only in his 20s. So the four leaders after our first block of races, Harold Simon, Luca Bauer, Frankie Zorn and Martin Harahiltunen, but the stats only tell half the story. On 2 points we have the Svenssons, Marcus Jell and Benedikt Mon, the replacement for Hans Weber. 1 point each for Järf, Divis, Olsen and Hutler, while Josetra, Franz.
So second and fourth in the championship standings, Luca Bauer with 18 championship points and Franz Zorn with 14.
Lining up then for heat number five, Frankie Zorn on three at race points for the day, goes off the inside in red. Gate number two in blue, it is Luca Bauer, also on three race points. Gate three in white, yet to score today, is Joe Saitra. And gate four in yellow, he'll be one to watch if he makes a good start. Jimmy Olsen in yellow for Sweden. The tapes go up and away they go. It's not a good start for Jimmy Olsen. It's a great start by Frankie Zorn. Here comes Luca Bauer on the outside off turn two. He takes the lead, or does he? Down the back straight, they're side by side, similar to their battles they had in the European Championship. And down goes Luca Bauer. He slid off there. He saves it. What a save! That is the save of the season from Luca Bauer. How he was down on the ice there. And not only has he saved it, he's still in second place ahead of Jimmy Olsen. How on earth has Luca Bauer done that?
Well, and Luca Bauer isn't done just yet. He almost loses it again going into turn at number three. He is pushing for all he is worth. But the one thing he can't afford is a non-score. And he took a look over his shoulder there coming off turn number four just to check on how close Jimmy Olsen was in third position. But he's a whole lot closer to the man ahead of him, Frans Zorn, than Jimmy Olsen is on his tail.
This race is not over yet. Luca Bauer is still going for it, giving it 101% here as he tries to close in on the European champion. They go down the back straight. Jimmy Olsen still third. He's dropped back. It's Josetra at the back, but Frankie Zorn pulls clear around the final turn. He is going to defeat Luca Bauer for the second time this weekend. Bauer comes over in second, and Jimmy Olsen completes the scorers.
Yes, Olsen has had two tough rides with which to start this meeting programme, and two third places as a result, beaten by Simon and Svensson in his opening outing, and coming off second best there against Frans Zorn and Luca Bauer. But Luca Bauer was the man very much in focus there in heat five. He was pushing for all he's worth. He gave it up on the final two turns, I think backed off down the back straight and didn't risk anything on those last two bends. He's actually taking a good inspection now of that top bend, just in case he needs to use that patch of ice again later on in the meeting, but he very nearly lost it. Save of the century, no doubt about that.
Yes, indeed. 3 points then for Frankie Zorn. He moves on to 6 race points today. Luca Bella on to 5. He's heading back to the pits to calm his nerves, I think. Jimmy Olsen in 3rd. He's on 2 points, and Jo Seitra yet to score.
Calm his nerves and change his pants, I suspect. Big moment there on turns 3 and 4, and he manages to gather it up quite nicely and come away with 5 points from 2 rides. But had he failed to score, he would have been in really the danger zone as far as potential qualification to the grand final is concerned. We now come out onto track for heat number 6, and the man in focus here will be Harold Simon, the winner of heat number 3 and a comfortable favourite in this company.
He's off gate number 2 in blue, 3 points to his name so far. Mats Jaff on 1 point off gate number 1 in red, the Finn. Gate 3 in white, yet to score is Franz Meyer-Buchler. And gate 4 in yellow, we have Lukas Hüttler, 1 point for the Czech from his first ride. He'll be probably the main challenger if you make a good start here to Harold Simon. Rider in blue will start as the favourite, takes up and away they go. A decent getaway by Mats Jaff from the inside. Harold Simon cuts across him. There's contact there between Jaff and Lukas Hüttler into the first turn. That's allowed Meyer-Buchler through into third, but it's Harold Simon who has the lead. Trying to challenge around the outside is the man in red, Mats Jaff. Goes a little bit too wide though off turn 4. Side by side for third as Hüttler recovers past Meyer-Buchler up into third place. But Mats Jaff, the 8 times Finnish champion, is not giving up. He's putting Harold Simon under some pressure here. He's having a look on the outside through turns 3 and 4. Simon moves out to defend. Always rides the tighter line through the turns. Mats Jaff is giving it a good go here. He's having a go up alongside as they come off turn 2. Could we be in for a shock here in this heat number 6? Jaff tries to pull ahead into turn 3. Hüttler behind them in 3rd. And Harold Simon once again holds off Mats Jaff.
Well, Harold Simmons super aggressive on Jaff, who's been going for the outside line throughout this race. Simmons not got much speed, to be perfectly honest. Hüttler's beginning to close the pair of them down. Final two turns.
Very close between the top 3 here. Jaff will give it one last effort off the final turn. I think he's going to do it. It's going to be side by side for second. Did Lukas Hüttler get there? That was very close indeed. I don't think he did. I think Mats Jaff held on. It is a win for Harold Simmons, but he seems to be struggling perhaps slightly with the conditions there.
Yes, well, Harold Simon preferring the inside line, and as the weekend goes on, and we've discussed it already, the ice gets rougher and rougher, the outside line is less used, and becomes an opportunity, and we know that was a great exhibition of ice speedway. Harold Simon loves the inside, Mats Jaff is an outside line expert, and the two of them were almost lock level throughout the 4 laps.
2 wins out of 2 for Harold Simon, then moves on to 6 points, confirmation it was Mats Jaff in second place, just held on there ahead of Lukas Hüttler. 3 points for Jaff so far, 2 for Hüttler, while Franz Meyer-Buchler still yet to score.
Now moving on then with heat number 7 and a matchup between Stefan Svensson and Martin Hara-Hiltunen as they resume their rivalry from recent Swedish championships. Stefan Svensson, who finished second to Martin Hara-Hiltunen in the Swedish final in 2023, also finished second to him in the competition last year, the Nordic final. Stefan Svensson was on the podium again behind Martin Hara-Hiltunen, and it's Hara-Hiltunen they've all got to beat if they want to challenge for the world title here this afternoon.
Stefan Svensson goes off the inside gate in red, his son Nicholas off gate number 2 in blue. Hara-Hiltunen in gate 3 in white. Well, Andrei Divish, the Czech Republic rider, will be rather up against it here, going from the outside against the 3 Swedes. Svensson, Hara-Hiltunen and Divish, heat number 7 goes, takes up, and it's a decent start by Nicholas Svensson. And for the first time perhaps this weekend, Hara-Hiltunen makes a poor start. He got some lift there, and it is the man in blue, Nicholas Svensson, who leads down the back straight. Stefan Svensson in 3rd. Now, are we going to see a shock result here? Is Martin Hara-Hiltunen's unbeaten run going to come to an end? He's on the inside as they go into turn 1 for the second time. Svensson on the outside, but Hara-Hiltunen goes through, shows his speed once again and takes the lead down the back straight for the second time. Bit out of shape in the ruts there that appeared on turns 3 and 4, but Hara-Hiltunen out in front once again.
Well, I think Nicholas Svensson was a little bit soft there on the opening lap and a half. He twice looked over his shoulder. Doesn't show a great deal of confidence, does it? And now Martin Hara-Hiltunen's beginning to gain a little bit of ground, but since being passed, Nicholas Svensson has largely kept up with him, and I think he might look back at this one as a missed opportunity to lure the colours of the reigning world champion. He led him for a lap. He's not going to get there at the checkered flag. Hara-Hiltunen beginning to break clear, and the biggest story of this one is probably not just one drop point, but two drop points for Stefan Svensson.
Yes, the win goes to Martin Harehilton, two out of two for the day for him, and that's eight wins for the weekend. Nicholas Svensson clearly frustrated with himself there in second. Stefan Svensson third, and Andre Divisch a long way behind.
I'm not surprised that Nicholas is a little bit frustrated because he had good speed. It was as though he knew and was disturbed by the fact that Martin Harehilton was behind him. Harehilton is so strong on pickup coming off turns two and four. You can't afford to leave him that cutback line. And Nicholas Svensson charging up to the outside made it all too easy for Martin Harehilton to come through. But someone's led him through a lap. That means perhaps you can do it over four.
That's the first time he's been led, Harehilton, this weekend. He moves on to 6 points. Nicholas Svensson is on to four for the day. Stefan Svensson is on three. He'll be a bit disappointed with that. Well, Andre Divisch was a long way back there at the finish. He remains on 1 point.
Next up then, heat number eight, and some of the lesser lights, with all due respect, in the meeting programme. We should have had Hans Weber going in the red helmet colour, but he, throughout this meeting, will be replaced by Benedikt Mon. The biggest favourite in this company will be Marcus Yell. Yell, the German, who finished in sixth position, was only a couple of heat points from a potential place in the grand final, just running out of steam in the closing stages against tough opposition. But he will be looking at this one as a banker race.
Yes, I certainly wouldn't term Marcus Yell as a lesser light, given his performance for sixth place yesterday. He's off gate number two in blue. Benedikt Mon, gate one in red. Gate three in white, Sebastian Reitzma. And it's Max Koivula with a chance of some points here off gate four in yellow. We are underway, and not surprisingly, it is Marcus Yell who makes a great start. Nearly clashes with Koivula on the run to the first turn. Yell leads it. Koivula up on the outside in second. Trademark slow start for Benedikt Mon. He's now come through into third place past the young Dutchman, Sebastian Reitzma. And we'll see Benedikt Mon going for the outside, but they're already well behind the pre-race favourite Marcus Yell, the German, pulling away in front, was beaten first time out by Martin Harehiltonen, now showing what he can do out in front as Max Koivula tries to hold off Benedikt Mon for second.
Yes, we know Benedikt Mon comes on stronger as races go on. We know that Max Koivula generally makes good starts and slips back, so we'll see if the two of them meet in the middle somewhere in the final laps of this one. And Mon again gaining in a lot of ground coming through turn one, but then dropping back slightly through turn two. He's going much harder into the turns than Koivula, but Koivula riding a good race at this stage.
Certainly is, yes, the Finn, who tends to make, he tends to be the opposite of Benedikt Mon, as we said earlier, tends to make quick starts and then drop back. But he's holding second place this time. They're well behind Marcus Yell, though. The German is heading for his first win of the day. The two-time German national champion takes the flag. Second place goes to Koivula, a decent ride by him. Benedikt Mon picks up a point in third, and more disappointment for Sebastian Reitzma at the back.
Yeah, solid start this afternoon for Marcus Yell. Beat Lukas Hüttler in his opening ride, heat number two, and takes the first race victory of the afternoon in that one. Marcus Yell won his opening ride yesterday, but didn't manage to win another race throughout the meeting programme, so he probably could do with at least one more win in the remainder. His races will get a little bit tougher than that one from here on in.
Marcus Yell, the winner, moves himself on to 5 points. Max Koivula opens his account on two. Third place for Benedikt Mon, he's on 3 points, while Sebastian Reitzma has still yet to pick up a race point this weekend. Well, that means we have three riders unbeaten on 6 points so far from their first two rides, Martin Harehilton and Frankie Zorn and Harold Simon, but they've all been made to work for it, to say the least. Marcus Yell and Luca Bauer are next on 5 points. Then Nicholas Svensson on four. On 3 points, we have Mats Jarv, Stefan Svensson and Benedikt Mon. Then on two, Max Koivula, Jimmy Olsen and Lukas Hüttler. Andre Divisch has a single point, while Reitzma, Seitra and Maya Buchla have all yet to get off the mark here on day two here of the World Championship at INZELL. And despite the slightly more loose ice conditions, we are seeing some quite superb racing here at the Max Eicher Arena. The track staff working hard to keep the...
Here's a race between the two men of the two outside starting positions. Luca Bauer, who finished second in Final One, and Stefan Svensson, who sits fifth in those championship standings. And they pull into line off the outside gates.
They're off the outside. Gate number one in red, Lukas Hüttler. He's on just 2 points so far. Max Koivula is off gate two in blue. He's also on two. Luca Bauer on 5 points off gate three. Stefan Svensson, gate four in yellow, is on 3 points, and he will do his darndest to take the fight to Luca Bauer here. This is heat number nine. They're underway. And of course, that first turn, Max Koivula makes a very good start in blue. He'll lead the way into the first turn, but here comes Luca Bauer around the outside. Koivula trying to hang on, but it is the rider in white, Luca Bauer, challenging. Koivula still there on the inside. This is impressive from the young Finn. Stefan Svensson, by contrast, made a poor start, and he's at the back at the moment. He tries to cut his way through into turn one, around the outside. Now Bauer takes up the lead through turn one. Svensson still struggling a little. He now gets around the outside of Lukas Huttner, whose disappointing weekend continues.
Svensson's got to get through into second place quickly, because while he doesn't, he comes under continued attack from Lukas Huttner. Koivula, I suspect, might hold up Stefan Svensson. He's got a little bit of daylight ahead of Huttner, needs to capitalise on it here.
Luca Bauer's away and gone. I don't think they're going to catch him now. And this is impressive from Max Koivula. Stefan Svensson is going to be getting fired up and angry in there in that third place. He could be on for something of a surprise result here. Can Stefan Svensson get through on the final turn? He's going to lunge down the inside of Max Koivula. He moves Koivula out wide. Excuse me, says Stefan Svensson. Bauer takes the win. Svensson does get the second place he wanted. Koivula in third. A good effort from him. And at the back, Lukas Huttner.
Very nice ride that from Stefan Svensson, as it turned out. An appalling start, left himself almost sleeping off the line. And those are the kind of reactions from a man perhaps in his mid-60s. But Stefan Svensson coming back through for second place. Cuts through on Lukas Huttner in straightforward fashion. But the important thing was for him to gap Huttner, because he was having to defend against the Czech whilst also attacking Max Koivula. Coming into the final lap, I didn't think Svensson was going to get there. He surges determinedly through in towards turn number three on the final lap. And that's the kind of ride that proves this is a world championship. Had Svensson finished in third, he would have been eliminated. Instead, he fires his way through for second place and just about keeps his hopes hanging by a thread. There's your result then of heat number nine. It's Bauer who wins it ahead of Svensson and Koivula. We're now on to track for the 10th race of the day. And while Svensson Senior took centre stage last time out, this time around it's Nicholas Svensson who is the man to watch. He's had two second places, but he has been competitive in both of his opening rides. And this race looks like it should be a potential race victory for him. He must convert it.
Especially as the other three riders in this race have all yet to score. Sebastian Reitzma off the inside in red. Jo Seitzra, gate two in blue. Svensson's off gate three in white. Gate four in yellow. It is Franz Meyerbuchler. So Nicholas Svensson, the hot favourite for this heat number 10. Let's see what he can do. He's made a decent start. So is Jo Seitzra, the Norwegian, alongside him. Away he goes, Nicholas Svensson. He'll just aim to get his head down and pull away in front of this one. Seitzra in second place. Then it's Franz Meyerbuchler up into third position. But Nicholas Svensson not pulling away by a massive margin at the moment. Jo Seitzra is going with him, picked up his first World Championship race victory in heats at number 12 yesterday, en route picking up 7 World Championship points, but it's Svensson away and clear.
Close battle out at the back as the rider in the yellow helmet colour, Franz Meyerbuchler, defends against Sebastian Reitzma. This could well settle the final points-paying positions for the World Championship in Final 2. Remember, the two of them were dicing it out for that single consolation point yesterday in Final 1. And again, Reitzma looking to get on terms with Franz Meyerbuchler in the closing stages.
This is better from the Dutchman, trying to get his first top three race finish of the meeting, chasing Franz Meyerbuchler. Someone's bike sounding rough as they came through turn one there. It is going to be a win as expected for Nicholas Svensson off the final turn to take the chequered flag. Second place goes to Jo Seitzra. Close run down to the line, but Meyerbuchler hangs on ahead of Sebastian Reitzma. More disappointments for the young Dutchman.
Yes, so it's Seitzra who gets the points as far as the trio squabbling for their first points of the meeting. Seitzra with two, then the Norwegian single point for Meyerbuchler, and Reitzma remains without defeating an opponent over the course of this meeting, and indeed failed to score yesterday as well. So as far as heat number 10 is concerned, the main story was Nicholas Svensson needed to bank the three race points, and he did so. You talked about him not looking particularly fast at the head of the field, not pulling away quickly. Bear in mind the riders are talking about how rough the ice is, and they don't want to risk falling off, particularly when they're in a safe first place. So heat number 10 to Svensson, first points of the meeting for Seitzra and Meyerbuchler. We now come out onto track for the 11th race of the day, and it's another Swede who will be in focus here, with Jimmy Olsen going in the blue helmet colour. Only 2 points from his opening two rides, but bear in mind he's had a tough draw at the start of this meeting. This race looks like it should be one where he will be expecting to pick up his first race victory of the afternoon.
But don't discount Marcus Yell. He's out again off gate number 3 in white, the German on 5 points. Jimmy Olsen is off gate 2, those 2 points in blue. It's Andrej Divisch off gate 1 in red, the Czech. He's on 1 point. Mats Jaff completes the lineup from gate four in yellow. So the riders in white and blue should be the two battling for victory here. I reckon this could be quite a close one if Jimmy Olsen is in good form here from gate number two in the blue helmet. The revs rise and away they go. And this is Olsen who gets away well. So does Yell. So does Divish there on the inside. It's going to be close around the first turn. And Olsen has been frozen out. He's at the back in blue because Mats Jaff came flying around the outside there on the first turn. Out in front it is Marcus Yell. Jaff goes up into second place. And Jimmy Olsen has a lot of work to do here to get back up on level terms with Marcus Yell. He's doing the third there, going into turn one, and he's going after Mats Jaff for second place.
Yes, Jimmy Olsen, who made a decent enough jump. The reaction time looked okay, but he popped down in the run towards turn at number one. He got through swiftly for third position, but Mats Jaff is a tougher proposition. Actually, Jaff is going after the race lead now.
Yeah, this is impressive from Mats Jaff, the 48-year-old Finn. He's pulled off one or two surprises here this weekend. Oh. And down goes Jimmy Olsen into the safety barrier at turn three. Just spun off there. So that will be the first race stoppage of the meeting. The riders were into the last lap, so I suspect the race will be awarded. We'll wait and confirm that in a moment.
That's the area on the circuit where Luca Bauer was inspecting earlier on, and that's where Jimmy Olsen has come down with some force into the bales on turn number three. Olsen a little bit out of luck, you'd say, this weekend. We've seen so much from him in the European Championship in particular, but he hasn't had an awful luck, a lot of luck this weekend here in INZELL. As I said previously, strong performer in that European Championship. He was fifth on his debut in the Euros back in 2014, and strong performer in the series in the last 2 years, finishing as the bronze medalist in 2023. And Swedish number three as well, Jimmy Olsen. Hopefully everything okay for him after coming down. The bike already being extracted from the scene. Blue disqualification light is on. There's no great surprise about that. Olsen was all on his own when he went down. As you said, the bike just letting go of him. First major incident we've really had this weekend so far here in INZELL. The ice condition has been very good for the riders, certainly through the opening final of 2023.
Yeah, we had a couple of minor falls yesterday and only one rider into the bales. Cheers go up from down there on turn three. Jimmy Olsen is up and appears to be okay. He's back on his feet, but he is disqualified from this heat number 11. And I can confirm the results has been awarded by referee Alexander Latozinski of Ukraine. Marcus Yell is your winner. Second goes to Mats Jaff, and Andrei Divish takes the consolation point in third.
So the race going as Marcus Yell needed it to then, with a second consecutive victory, moves him on to 8 points in the qualification stages out of a possible nine. As I said previously, though, he's got his toughest races still to come, heats 14 and 20. So that was a race where he needed the 3 race points. He got them ahead of Jimmy Olsen, and Olsen all at sea. And walking away, looks in a little bit of discomfort, just checking himself down as he makes his way back to the pits. Fingers crossed we get to see more of Jimmy Olsen. He's got a match-up in prospect with his fellow countryman Niklas Svensson in Heat 16, the two of them somewhat rivals. And Olsen will then be back out onto track for Heat 18, which is something of a low-scorer's race. So every chance that he could finish strong in this meeting if he is still fit after what was a heavy spill there in the closing stages of Heat number 11.
Yeah, he had a couple of big crashes in the European Championship in Poland last month as well on his way to an eventual podium spot. Looked in some pain on the rostrum afterwards, so he's a bit of an incident-prone rider, sadly, is Jimmy Olsen, but plenty of years ahead of him to improve.
Well, look, he came under a lot of criticism when he made his return in the European Championship in 2022. Frans Zorn labelling his riding style as dangerous, and after the pair came together, and Frans Zorn left Sanok with an injury, of course, in those European Championships, fractured vertebrae. But Jimmy Olsen is a forceful rider. He's a determined rider. He's an entertainer. And no doubt about it, it's great to have him back in the World Championship after a few seasons out due to a ban. So now we're coming on to track for Heat 12, that last one being awarded. And this is the big one as far as round three is concerned. We've got three previously unbeaten men set to meet. And two of them, Martin Harahiltunen and Frans Zorn, who finished first and fourth in final one yesterday. When they met in heat three yesterday, they actually touched at one stage. Harahiltunen going on to victory. He'll be looking to maintain his winning run here.
Harry Hiltonen goes off gate number one then in the red helmet. It's Benedict Mon, gate two in blue. Frankie Zorn, gate three in white. And gate four in yellow, it's Harold Simon. The three unbeaten riders after their first two rides. Completing the lineup, it is Benedict Mon on 3 points. Could he cause an upset here by getting in among those grand final contenders? Harry Hiltonen from the inside, can they outpace him? Is he going to make another sluggish start? We're about to see the red prize for this crucial heat number 12. Away they go, and it's Zorn making the best getaway. Harry Hiltonen will tuck in behind him into the first turn. Harry Hiltonen up the inside, through he goes, and away goes Martin Harry Hiltonen. Once again, no problem at all down the back straight. Frankie Zorn in second place. It's Simon riding the tight line as always in third. Benedict Mon left playing catch up in this one, as we expected. The battle, I think, is going to be for second place here between the two Austrians. They almost clashed in the grand final yesterday as they fought for third place. But Benedict Mon, don't write him off just yet. He's going for the outside on Harold Simon. We could perhaps see a surprise there.
Well, Simon needs to make sure he holds on for at least this single heat point, as Frans Zorn bobbles coming off the second bend, looks over his shoulder, checks on the gap that he's still got fairly sizable over Harold Simon. But Simon is struggling now to hold back Benedict Mon out at the back of the field. I think he's just about got it now into the final lap.
Well, Benedict Mon riding the wider line, seems to be the quicker line at the moment. No stopping Martin Harrah-Hiltonen. He's heading for his ninth race win of the weekend. Comes out of the final turn well clear of Frankie Zorn. Harrah-Hiltonen keeps up his unbeaten run. First defeat of the day for Zorn and for Simon. Good effort, though, by Benedict Mon there to try and catch Simon, but he has to settle for fourth.
Credit to the meeting reserve, Benedict Mon. 3 points from three rides for him, but it was all about the three previously unbeaten men coming into that one at Heat 12, and it was Martin Harrah-Hiltonen, where there could be only one, as they say in Highlander, and it was Harrah-Hiltonen who did the job for his third race victory of the day. For me, Frans Zorn made a mistake there in the run down towards turn number one. He made the jump, he was comfortably clear of Harrah-Hiltonen, and he cut to the inside, rode too acute into that first turn. Harrah-Hiltonen loves the cutback coming off the second bend. He was always going to try that move. I think Frans Zorn, if he'd taken a wider arc, might have been able to block Harrah-Hiltonen's cutback coming off the second bend, but Zorn clearly didn't realise how much of an advantage he had away from the tapes and in terms of reaction time on Harrah-Hiltonen, and the Swede swiftly moved through down the back straight, and he was gone from there.
Result confirmed then. Harrah-Hiltonen still unbeaten on 9 points. Frankie Zorn moves on to eight, and Harold Simon is now on seven with that third place. Benedict Mon remains on three. So Martin Harrah-Hiltonen now moves clear at the top of the standings by a point. He's the only unbeaten rider so far. Zorn, Marcus Yell and Luca Bauer now all on eight, so they're in grand final places as it stands at the moment. Just a point behind them, Harold Simon and Niklas Svensson. They're not out of contention just yet. The gap behind them is 2 points. Mats Jaff going well, and Stefan Svensson, they're both on 5 points. We've got Max Kuivila on three, as is Benedict Mon, and then four riders on 2 points. Jos Seitra, Andre Divisch, Lucas Hutler and Jimmy Olsen, unlucky there with that tumble in Heat 11. 1 point for Franz Meyerbuchler, and Sebastian Reitzma still yet to get off the mark this weekend on his World Championship debut. Harrah-Hiltonen moves clear then. That Heat 20 is looking ever more crucial here this weekend. Yell, Bauer, Simon and Svensson. That's going to definitely decide, I think, the last couple of grand final places. Harrah-Hiltonen clear at the top, and there certainly is a gap between the top six and the rest of the field, just starting to open up slightly now, with Harold Simon and Niklas Svensson 2 points clear of Stefan Svensson and Mats Jaff. Jaff has given a good account of himself so far here in Insel this weekend. Was challenging Marcus Yell in Heat 11. He was challenging Harold Simon in Heat 6 as well. A great race between those two. Could we see Mats Jaff make an impression a little bit later on? Draw is perhaps
in points, and in final two he leads him by just a single point. It's 9-8 in favour of Martin Harrah-Hiltonen in terms of qualifying. Bauer was beaten by Zorn in Heat 5, so if he wants to have a hope of top seeding position to the final and choice of starting position, he'll likely need to beat Harrah-Hiltonen here. Meanwhile, it's a last shot at glory for Mats Jaff, who really needs a win in tough company.
He's off gate three in white. It's Harrah-Hiltonen off gate number four in yellow. Luca Bauer on the inside in red. Sebastian Reitzma completes the lineup, going from gate two in the blue helmet colour. The riders in red and yellow will be the ones to watch here. They should be battling for the victory. Harrah-Hiltonen out on top, just a point ahead of Luca Bauer, 9 plays 8. Can Bauer become the first this weekend to defeat Martin Harry-Hilton? We'll find out over the next four laps. Well, Bauer gets away well, so does Harry-Hilton into the first turn. The Swede around the outside takes up the running, coming through turn two, and away he goes once again down the back straight. I think the order may well be set from there, but you never know. We saw Luca Bauer nearly lose it. Well, he did lose it earlier on, but saved it. He's in second place. He's going after Martin Harry-Hilton, and further back in third is Yarth. His hopes of making the grand final could be extinguished here. And Sebastian Reitzma at the back, getting some lift down the back straight, but it's still Harry-Hilton and out in front. Bauer not able to close in as yet.
Yes, Luca Bauer would have certainly liked to take the race victory, but it's going to be far from disastrous to score second place. He'll move on to 10 with a ride to spare, but he is going to be under pressure in that final outing as a result of dropping that single point in Heat 5 and this one in Heat 13.
It's the last lap we go then. The lead about half the length of the straights for Martin Harry-Hilton. A little bit of a slip there over the ruts at turns one and two. He looks back behind him to see where Luca Bauer is. I don't think there's going to be any major problem here. Harry-Hilton will come in to take win number four for the afternoon. Luca Bauer comes over in second. Back to the third, fairly close. Matyaf takes third ahead of Sebastian Reitzma.
So that means that Martin Harry-Hilton remains clear at the top of the meeting classification. Luca Bauer now drops 2 heat points behind him. So it's 12 for Harry-Hilton and 10 for Bauer. Matyaf on to 6 points, and that rules him now out of contention for a place in today's grand final. But it has been a competitive display this weekend for him nonetheless. 9 world championship points yesterday, and he should be mid-table again this afternoon.
So Martin Harry-Hilton picks up the win. He's unbeaten on 12. Luca Bauer second, moves on to 10 points. Matyaf in third, as you just said, he's on 6. And that will rule him out of a grand final place. Sebastian Reitzma has still yet to score after 4 rides.
Heat 14 will see a matchup between Fran Zorn and Stefan Svensson, and it is last chance now for glory for Stefan Svensson as well. If he wants a place on the medal rankings in the medal table for 2023, he likely needs to win his 2 remaining heats to qualify to the grand final. Remember, he was 5th in final 1, and he won't want to miss out narrowly on a place in the final here today. Fran Zorn, meanwhile, only a single point behind Martin Harry-Hilton after the 3rd round of races, winner of heats 4 and 5, and he's likely to pose the stiffest test to Svensson's hopes of making it through inside that lead quartet.
This is going to be a close one here. Marcus Yell off the outside gate in yellow, currently on 8 points. Stefan Svensson alongside him in white, he's currently on 5, needs a win here. Frankie Zorn is on 8 points, completing the lineup. Franz Meyer-Buchler with 1 point goes off the inside in red, the German wildcard nomination. This is going to be close between the 3 men from the outside. 3 gates here, I would think. The revs begin to rise, and away they go. Good start by Frankie Zorn. Decent start by Stefan Svensson as well. Not the best getaway for Marcus Yell this time. He tries to slot in on the inside. He goes through down the back straight, up in the second place, side by side with Svensson, who fights back on the outside line, retakes that second place. Good race here in this heat at number 14. It's Frankie Zorn who has the lead, the European champion. They've already dropped Franz Meyer-Buchler, the 3 battling for the points paying position. It's Frankie Zorn now starting to pull away in the lead.
Stefan Svensson will know he needs the win here. We saw that he fought his way through in his 3rd ride through caution to the wind in heat 9 to get 2nd position. He should do the same in the latter stages here against Franz Zorn. He cuts to the inside around turns 1 and 2. The pair of them side by side, and Svensson leads us down the back straight on lap number 3.
Oh, brilliant from Stefan Svensson. There's life in the old dog yet. He's through down the back straight. He leads Frankie Zorn, who won't be yet too happy with this. He'll try and fight back. What is Frankie Zorn going to do into the final turn? Yell is there on the inside in 3rd place. I don't think Frankie Zorn's going to do it. And Yell's closing up on Zorn. Has Zorn got a problem, I wonder? He's going to hang on for 2nd, but Svensson wins it. He needed that. 2nd place goes to Frankie Zorn. A surprise result there. 3rd place, it's Marcus Yell. And well behind in 4th was Franz Meyer-Buchler.
Crucial race that for Stefan Svensson. I said so before the tapes went up. And late on, he was willing to ride through the ruts on the inside. And this is going to be critical. The outside's the place to be. Make no mistake about that. But it is also the longest route. And if you're brave, you go through the ruts on the inside. You hope for the best and you find your way through. And Stefan Svensson making that line work to hit the front. An important pass in Heat 9. An important pass in Heat 14. He is still going to be relying on other riders dropping points because of that 3rd place back in Heat 7. But Svensson keeping his hopes alive once again.
3 points then for Stefan Svensson. He moves moves on to eight. And if he wins his final ride, he's got a fairly easy draw. He is still in with a chance. Frankie Zorn, second place, moves on to 10 points. Third for Marcus Yell. He's now on nine. And at the back was Franz Meyer-Buchler. He remains on one.
There's a little bit more movement in the points today in terms of riders taking points from one another as well. Niklas Svensson looking more competitive. We know Max Jarf has been able to mix it with the riders. Franz Zorn's dropped 2 points during their heat stages today. Luca Bauer likewise. So that will lower the threshold of points needed potentially to make it through to the grand final. So that might just give a hope to Stefan Svensson. Well, we're coming into line now for the next one, heat number 15. And we watch out for Harold Simon as far as those qualification positions are concerned in this one. He's on 7 points from three rides.
Max Koivula is off the inside gate in red. It's Andre Divish, gate two in blue. Simon goes from gate three. Go Saitra from the outside in yellow. Takes up and away they go. Not a great start by Harold Simon. He could be last. He is last going into the first turn. It's the man in red, Max Koivula, the Finn, who leads away. Simon cuts through on the inside into second place underneath Andre Divish and Jo Saitra, now going after Max Koivula for the lead. We know Simon likes to ride the inside line. Is it going to work at this later stage of the meeting, though? We know Koivula likes the wider line, and the Finn looking for his first World Championship victory, but Simon breezes past him coming out of turn two. The experienced Austrian into the lead. It is really bumpy now going into turn three, but Koivula is fighting back. There's a good fight for third as well between Divish and Saitra. Two races in one here in this heat 15.
This is why experience is so important, because you've got to judge it to perfection. It's not only about the right suspension setup and the speed out on track. It's also about how you ride the ruts, how you defend position, and Harold Simon is the master of that. You can see how close he goes to the bales down the straights to pin his rival out of track position. Still a race going on for third position as well.
Yes, Jo Saitra has just taken third place. Here comes Koivula up the inside on Harold Simon. He goes through into the final turn. Simon will try and cut it back. It's going to be a drag race to the line. A photo finish. I think Koivula just got it. Incredible. Koivula wins it. Now that could be critical. Simon second, and we'll wait confirmation of who was third. I think Jo Saitra got it.
Well, bear in mind that Simon still got to face Luca Bauer and Niklas Svensson in heat 20. He will go a point ahead of Stefan Svensson into the final round of races, but Stefan Svensson looks like he's got a much easier draw in heat number 17. So that battle for fourth position that we saw between the two of them yesterday could be repeated here today. At the moment, Marcus Yell also inside at those top four places, as Max Koivula is confirmed as your race winner in heat number 15, and that has got to be one of the biggest shocks of the weekend so far. I said more riders have been taking points from one another. Case in point from heat 15.
Well, Harold Simmons in that elimination shootout in heat number 20, and that won't help him. He's only on 9 points now. The win going to Max Koivula. He moves on to six.
On now to heat 16, last then of the round four heat races. Niklas Svensson on 7 points. He is the man to watch, as Niklas Svensson sits 2 points behind Marcus Yell and Harold Simon, who are currently tied for the fourth of those qualification positions. Svensson then, the winner of heat number 10, looking for another victory here.
Heat 16, Jimmy Olsen goes off the inside gate in red. He's on just 2 points. Lucas Hutler also on two, gate two in blue. Benedict Morn at gate three in white. Niklas Svensson goes off the outside in yellow. Needs a win here, just like his father did in his previous ride. Away they go. Olsen gets away well, so does Svensson. It's Svensson who hits the front, around the outside into the first turn. Trying to go for the outside is Lucas Hutler in blue. That's holding the inside, Jimmy Olsen. This is where he fell in his previous ride, going into turn three. Side by side with Hutler, this time through. Benedict Mon once again playing catch-up, and Jimmy Olsen is not letting Niklas Svensson get away here. The two Swedes scrapping it out at the front, and Svensson nearly overcooks it through turn two. It's close between the two. They go nose to tail through turns three and four. Hutler keeping a watching brief in third. Here comes Jimmy Olsen on the inside, going into turn one for the third time. Is he going to take the lead? Niklas Svensson fights back on the outside, and Jimmy Olsen takes the lead from Niklas Svensson. Svensson fights back up the outside into turn three. Terrific race between the three of them, because Lucas Hutler is in there as well. They're almost three wide down the straight. Hutler's going through into second place. This could be disaster for Niklas Svensson. He's got to fight back. He's got to fight back. This is dreadful news for Niklas Svensson. He's down to third. He's got to go for the outside on the final turn. It's going to be all or nothing for Niklas Svensson. Oh, Hutler's gone down through the final turn. Olsen wins it. That's gifted Svensson second. Benedict on third, and Lucas Hutler is down.
Big, big get out of jail free card there for Niklas Svensson, as Lucas Hutler goes down. looked to have that second position. He was going for first. It really has been a miserable weekend as far as Lucas Hüttler is concerned. Jimmy Olsen was always going to be the biggest threat to Niklas Svensson in that one, and so it proved. He's nicked a point off him there. And that will mean that we go into the final round of heat races with three men tied or nine in the last of those provisional qualification positions, and only 1 point ahead of them, the men in second and third. It's that much closer for those qualification places, and four of those men will appear in heat number 20. What a big climax this is going to be to the heat stages.
Oh, yes, it certainly will be. Heat number 16, then the result confirmed. Jimmy Olsen is your winner. He moves on to 5 points as a result of that. Niklas Svensson, a lucky second. He's still there on nine. Benedikt Mon is now on 4 points. Lucas Hüttler, a faller. He remains on two. It's not been a happy weekend for the Czechs. He's up and okay, though. That is the main thing. That means Martin Harrahiltunen now leads overall, but it's anybody's race for the remaining grand final places. Harrahiltunen surely safe to get through with 12 points. Frankie Zorn and Luca Bauer both have 10. Bauer's in that shootout in heat 20, along with Marcus Jell, Harald Simon and Niklas Svensson. They're all on 9. Behind them, Stefan Svensson is on 8, and he's not out of contention yet either, if he can win heat 17. Behind them, Max Kuivila is on 6, as is Mats Järf. And Jimmy Olsen on 5. Benedikt Mon has 4. Josecha 3. Andre Divisch and Lucas Hüttler on 2 points apiece. Franz Meyer-Buchler 1. No score so far for Sebastian Reitzma, the Dutchman. So Martin Harrahiltunen will make his way into the grand final.
Put himself back in the qualification places on 11.
Here we go then, lining up for 8.17. Josecha goes off the inside gate in red. He's on 3 points. Gate 2 in blue. It's Mats Järf. He's on 6. Stefan Svensson, the man we're watching in gate 3 in white. He's on 9 points. 8 points, I should say. Going off gate 4 in yellow, it is Benedikt Mon. He's on 4. Stefan Svensson needs a win here to keep his grand final hopes alive, and then he'll have to wait it out to see what happens in the next three heats. Mats Järf should be his main challenger here in blue. Just awaiting the all clear from down there on turn 4. Once race director Phil Morris is happy, the red flag will be withdrawn. That green flag now goes in the air on turn 4. It's time to go racing once again. Heat number 17, Setra, Järf, Svensson and Mon takes up, and away they go. Good start by Stefan Svensson from gate 3 in white. He leads Mats Järf into the first turn, into the back straight, already starting to pull away. Järf in second, Jo Setra up into third place. A quieter day today from the Norwegian. Benedikt Mon, his usual slow start, now going for the outside on Josecha, can't get through on turn 4. But Mats Järf is not letting Stefan Svensson get away. Stefan Svensson's hit a rut through turns 1 and 2, and here comes Mats Järf up the outside. This could be disaster for the veteran if Mats Järf beats him. They could be out of the grand final. They tangle, they both go down on turn 4. Now we'll have to wait and see what the referee's decision is on that. Down go Mats Järf and Stefan Svensson into the bales on turn 4.
Well, you could easily make a case that both riders were the cause of that stoppage, because for me, Mats Järf was already...
Benedikt Mon's mechanic there, cooling the clutch on his machine by putting loose ice from the track onto it. I've never seen that before.
That as well. Yes, absolutely. Here we go then. Three riders only for the restaging of heat 17.
Josecha off gate number 1 in red. Mats Järf off gate 2 in blue. And Benedikt Mon, gate 3 in yellow. Mon could cause surprise here. He's got room to manoeuvre on the outside. But Järf will start as the favourite. Red fries, and away they go for the rerun. Good start by Josecha from the inside in red, the Norwegian. But Järf goes around the outside. The Finn takes it up, coming out of turn 2. Top 2 pull clear of Benedikt Mon down the back straight. I hope I haven't put the curse of the commentator on him here. He may move up to challenge as the race goes on. Josecha for second place. But away goes Mats Järf in the lead.
Well, we know that Mon is a slow starter, but he's beginning to wind it up here.
Yes, he certainly has had a look there, coming off turn 2. He's not close enough just yet. Here comes Mon around the outside on that rather bumpy turns 3 and 4. Setra now goes wide. This is allowing Mats Järf to escape in the lead. All the focus is going to be on the battle for second place in the closing stages. Again, Josecha runs wide, coming off turn 2. Mats Järf is heading for the 3 points, and this will take him up to 9. As here comes Benedikt Mon on the inside this time, changing tack as he attacks Josecha. He's going for him on turns 1 and 2. They're going to be side by side. Setra closes the door. It's going to be a win for Mats Järf. This will improve his world championship standing this year. He's given a good account of himself this weekend. Järf comes in to win it. Mon at the inside off the final turn. Doesn't quite get there. Good defensive work. by Jo Seitra for second place.
So Matt Scharf bookends his weekend here in Insel. He had a victory in his opening ride of Final One. He has a victory in his last ride of Final Two. It is 9 points that he now moves on to, and that looks likely to give him seventh position in the meeting classification here today. Certainly moves him above Stefan Svensson and into that position. Devastation for Svensson. Matt Scharf happy enough with his result in the restaging.
Yes, that moves Matt Scharf, as you say, Alex, onto 9 points. He's now above Stefan Svensson in the classification. 2 points for Jo Seitra there. He's now on five, as is Benedict Mon with that third place. Their meeting comes to an end, but they'll finish outside the top 10 in today's meeting.
So now we move on to Heat 18, and the story in this one is all about Martin Haara-Hiltunen. On 12 points, he's already through to today's grand final. Even if he were to fail to score here, his four race victories would give him a position thanks to countback. But he needs just a single point from this race to be sure of top seeding position to the grand final. He, of course, will be looking for a win to maintain his unbeaten run here in Insel.
Top seed, of course, gets the first grid draw in the ballot for gate positions. Haara-Hiltunen goes off the inside gate in red. Gate two in blue is Jimmy Olsaid. It's Franz Meyer-Buchler. Gate three in white. Max Kuivila, a surprise winner last time out against Harald Simon, goes off the outside gate in yellow for Finland. Let's begin to rise then. Haara-Hiltunen, Olsaid, Meyer-Buchler and Kuivila takes up and away they go. Kuivila making another one of his trademark fast starts, goes level with Haara-Hiltunen briefly, but Martin Haara-Hiltunen takes up the running around the first turn, heading for an unbeaten score and top seeding for the grand final for the second day in a row. Kuivila holding second ahead of Jimmy Olsaid. Franz Meyer-Buchler is at the back. Battle could be joined here for second place, though, as Olsaid tries to look on the inside. But the outside line is the smoother at this stage. Kuivila just about hanging on as they go down the back straight. Will Jimmy Olsaid try a move here into turns three and four? He's up alongside almost Max Kuivila, going for the inside down the home straight. He goes through, completes the move up in a second, but by this stage, Haara-Hiltunen is away and gone.
You've got to love Jimmy Olsaid, haven't you? Only 2 points from his opening three rides. He's going to pick up 5 heat points from his last two outings just to prove what might have been a tough weekend for him. But as I said previously, he never throws in the towel, as that pass there on Kuivila proved for the second position.
It's Martin Haara-Hiltunen once again away and clear at the front. He's going to complete a maximum from the qualifying heats. 11 wins out of 11 races so far this weekend for Martin Haara-Hiltunen. Second for Jimmy Olsaid. Third is Max Kuivila. And Franz Meyer-Buchler, a disappointing weekend for him, finishes at the back.
So Martin Haara-Hiltunen going through the card, and that guarantees him first choice of starting positions in the ballot that we'll see after heat number 20. And Haara-Hiltunen absolutely untouchable so far this weekend, but it could all still be taken away from him in the grand final.
Martin Haara-Hiltunen then finishes his qualifying rides unbeaten on 15 points. Jimmy Olsaid with second moves on to 7. He finishes with 7 points, as does Max Kuivila. He's given a decent account of himself today. Franz Meyer-Buchler just the 1 point from today. He'll finish towards the foot of the score chart.
Yes, Max Kuivila will remain above Jimmy Olsaid inside the top 10 positions in the meeting classification. Kuivila with a win, a second and two thirds. Win and second and two thirds for Jimmy Olsaid as well, but he had the disqualification in heat 11. So that's what's going to separate the two of them in today's meeting classification. But that's all for the minor placings. And as for the grand final positions, well, heat number 19, the next one, could go some way to settling one of them at least. Martin Haara-Hiltunen has already booked his position through. Fran Zorn looking to confirm his place in the penultimate qualifier of the day. He's on 10 points as things stand, and a victory will make absolutely sure as far as Zorn is concerned.
And this looks like a bit of a banker for Zorn, because Andre Divisch is his opposition off gate one in red. Gate two is Sebastian Reitzma in blue, and Lucas Hutler, gate four in yellow. Zorn goes off gate three in white, beaten last time out by Stefan Svensson, of course, in heat number 14. But Franz Zorn starts as the favourite here for heat number 19. Away they go. Andre Divisch making a decent start from the inside in red. Zorn will go for the outside through turns one and two. But no, Divisch holds the lead. A surprise here down the back straight for the first time. Zorn moves to the inside. Lucas Hutler, rather, in third place in the yellow helmet. The two Czechs, are they trying to ride a team race here against Franz Zorn, I wonder? Well, it's not working at the moment, because Zorn goes to the outside and takes up the lead into the back straight. And now Lucas Hutler will try and get past Andre Divisch. Lucas Suttler on the attack. He wants to go through into the lead here. He fell in his last ride. He's up into second, but it's Fran Zorn now away at the front.
Very intelligent riding that from Fran Zorn. You said it. He ducked to the inside, down the back straight in the early stages, thought about making the lunge, but switched out of it and went for the outside attack. He didn't want to risk what happened to Stefan Svensson happening to him, because that's the only way he's going to be deprived of a place in the grand final. By my reckoning, even if he gets passed by Lucas Hutler here and ends up in second position, that should be enough. Race on out at the back for consolation only. Up front, Fran Zorn about to book his place in today's grand final.
Here he comes to the line. Hutler closes. It's too late. Zorn wins it. Hutler second, and a very pleased Sebastian Reitzma got through for third on the last lap. He's celebrating like he's just won the meeting. Finally gets a point in his last ride of his first ever world final, got ahead of Andre Dibich. Well done, Sebastian Reitzma.
And he will be pleased just to have claimed a scalp over the course of this weekend. Just 16 years of age, remember. And the Dutch nomination, the Netherlands deprived of the services of Jasper Iwema in 2023. But Reitzma holding up their honour with a consolation point in that one.
Oh, absolutely brilliant there from Sebastian Reitzma on the last lap. It's a win for Frankie Zorn. He moves on to 13 points for today and books his place in the grand final. Lucas Hutler in second improves to 4 points after a disappointing day. Reitzma gets 1 point, and the unfortunate Andre Dibich remains on two.
Well, it's time for some permutations then, isn't it? Martin Hara-Hilton is already through on 15. Fran Zorn, with victory there in heat 19, books his place inside that lead quartet. We've got four men separated by just 1 point lining up next time out in heat 20. Only two of them can go through to the grand final. Luca Bauer is the man who's got the advantage by a single qualifying point over Marcus Yell, Harald Simon and Niklas Svensson. If any of those latter three were to win this race, they would guarantee themselves a place in the final. Yell, remember, has a single heat victory. Harald Simon has two, and Niklas Svensson has one. So in terms of countback, it is Harald Simon who is in a strong position. Yell as well, the winner of heat 8 and 11, and Niklas Svensson just with that one win. So he's the man who trails them in the pecking order. Coming into it, Luca Bauer within touching distance. First and second position should be enough for him, although it could be tight if he doesn't win it. And any of Yell, Simon and Svensson will all be looking for a win to confirm their places on 12.
It's Yell, Svensson, Simon and Bauer underway for heat number 20. This is the eliminator, effectively, and it's Niklas Svensson in blue who's made a great start. Luca Bauer tries to get around the outside. Simon up the inside. Bauer relegated to third place. Now we're going to have to do some mathematics if it's going to stay like this. Luca Bauer trying to get up the outside. Simon determined after that surprise defeat by Max Koivula earlier on. Simon goes to the inside. Niklas Svensson cuts across him. They almost collided there. Oh, and a collision at the back, and into the bales goes Marcus Yell. He clipped the back wheel of Luca Bauer, I think, there. Race stopped. Marcus Yell is down. Kicks the straw bale in disgust. That's going to spell the end of his qualification hopes. That's a great shame after a brilliant effort by the German champion. Well, everybody going for every point possible in that one. And with Niklas Svensson making the start, he was leading the way ahead of Luca Bauer, who was battling out with Harald Simon. Then Simon coming through to try and take lead. The red disqualification light is on for Marcus Yell. He came down through turn two after clipping the back wheel, I think, of Luca Bauer there. That straightened him up, and he went straight on into the barrier. So that's the end of Marcus Yell's hopes of qualifying for the grand final. That's one Luca Bauer reprieve, because he dropped back into third place, and that would have shaken things up a little, shall we say, if it had finished like that. So the three remain. Luca Bauer on 10 points, Simon on 9, Svensson on 9. Marcus Yell, we know, will finish on 9, and that's going to end his hopes of getting into today's grand final. We'll have to do as we say, a bit of mathematical work to try and work out the permutations of who's got to do what in this rerun now. And I believe, Alex, you've had the calculator out that last couple of minutes.
Well, it's been very complicated today. Yesterday it was nice and easy, wasn't it? We'd set things up how they were going to be in heat 17, 18 and 19, but heat 20 is a lot more complicated. The situation now is that obviously we've got three riders contesting two remaining places for the grand final. Marcus Yell has made our calculations a little bit more straightforward. Luca Bauer leads Harald Simon and Niklas Svensson by a single point. Svensson only has one heat win compared to two for Harald Simon. But Svensson, obviously, if he beats Simon here, is going to move above him in the meeting classification. So if Svensson goes and wins it, he'd move on to 12. If Simon were to finish second, he would move on to 11. And Luca Bauer collects a single point, he would move on to 11 as well. Bauer already has two heat wins, so does Harold Simon. So it's going to go certainly right down to the wire between the two of them. And it could even come down to who beats who in this one, heat number 20. So Bauer can't really afford to finish in third place. He needs a top two finish, but so does Simon, and so does Svensson.
Marcus Jell giving a lift on the tractor back to the pits with his machine, a long way back from turn two to the pit entrance here at INZELL. As the rest of the riders wait patiently, the two-minute warning now sounds for the rerun of this critical heat number 20. Luca Bauer on 10, the other two riders, Harold Simon and Niklas Svensson, on 9. So we'll have to wait to do some more arithmetic maybe after this one to see who goes through.
Don't worry, I'll be on it during it, Dave. We'll be A-OK.
You handle the mathematics. You're better at maths than I am.
First rider up to the tapes then for the restaging of heat number 20 as Marcus Jell's bike is elevated away from the circuit. Looks as though we're just about ready to go. That service vehicle will clear the track. And then this is the big one. And it's a particularly big one if your name is Luca Bauer. Niklas Svensson down in seventh in the championship is already out of the running for the world title. But Luca Bauer and Harold Simon need the right result here. Having been podium finishers yesterday, neither can afford to take only third position in this, the last of the qualifying heats.
Here we go then. Niklas Svensson off gate two in blue, gate three in white, Harold Simon, gate four in yellow. Is Luca Bauer, who is going through. We're just waiting for the pit gate to go together down there after Marcus Jell's bike was recovered. Waiting the all clear from the officials down there. We get the green flag on turn four. Start marshal will now get them into line. Svensson, Simon and Bauer, the eliminator, take two, gets underway down towards that first turn. It's Bauer who gets away well, so does Niklas Svensson. They bounce over the ruts, so they both go wide. Simon up the inside, it's almost a repeat of the first running. Harold Simon goes to the front. Luca Bauer's going to go for broke. Around outside there, three wide through turns three and four. This is incredible. Simon somehow holds the lead. Niklas Svensson in second place. Luca Bauer has got to attack, attack, attack from third place. Here comes Svensson now. He bounces wide through turn two. Simon's got away in the lead. Seems to be learning the conditions better than the others are. Niklas Svensson makes a mistake through turns three and four, but Luca Bauer not in position to capitalise.
Luca Bauer in real trouble here. He needs to get through on Niklas Svensson. Big bobble again coming off turn two for Harold Simon.
I thought Niklas Svensson was going to hit the back of Simon there as he went into turns one and two. He's trying again around the outside. Luca Bauer is dropping away. Could we see his world championship hopes start to end here?
Well, he might be saved unless Svensson beats Simon, and Simon has been picked off there by Svensson coming through turns one and two, and this is the worst possible scenario now for Luca Bauer, who goes for broke around the outside on the final two turns.
Here comes Luca Bauer. Is he going to do it? I don't think he's going to. It's a photo finish for the win. I don't know who got that. Luca Bauer only third.
Svensson for me.
Oh, and Simon into the bales at the end of the after the flag there.
Svensson for me, and I think that's going to be Luca Bauer eliminated.
Goodness,
we're going to wait
me.
For confirmation of that result. If Niklas Svensson won it, he moves through on 12. Harold Simon, if he takes second, would be on 11. So would Luca Bauer. But he's just been beaten by Harold Simon. There's no doubt about that. We wait for official confirmation, but I think that Luca Bauer's world championship tilt is over. And I think that Niklas Svensson and Harold Simon will go through to the final, and that will give us a shootout between Harry Hilton and Zorn and Simon for those World Championship podium places.
Results about to come in, and yes, Svensson has got it. Svensson the winner.
And Luca Bauer is eliminated after Heat 20. He will not move through to the grand final. His World Championship hopes are at an end. Luca Bauer finishes on 30 World Championship points. Martin Hara-Hilton, and of course, guaranteed at least 14 from the grand final, and will therefore finish off.
Truly incredible bit of ice racing there. Well done to Niklas Svensson. Bad luck to Luca Bauer. So the four qualifiers are known then. Hara-Hilton and Zorn, Svensson and Simon on countback with Luca Bauer, Marcus Jell, Mats Jarf and Stefan Svensson completing the top eight in the standings after heat number 20. Let's head down to the pits in just a moment with Alex Raby. Shortly we'll be able to hear from them down there for the ballot for grid positions for the final. Hara-Hilton will of course get the top is next out. He'll be on gate one in red. Gate three in the white helmet will be the European champion, Frankie Zorn. And gate four in yellow, it is Harold Simon, looking for his first ever individual world championship medal.
Don't forget that Luca Bauer at the moment still sits on 30 world championship points. Frankie Zorn, if he were to finish at the back, would only move on to 24. There are still the other medal positions up for grabs, but the focus, quite rightly, will be on gold.
Here we go then. The revs beginning to rise already. We're just waiting for Frankie Zorn to pull forward in white. Who is going to take that coveted gold medal? Svensson, Harahiltunen, Zorn, and Simon. Can Martin Harahiltunen retain the title? He's unbeaten so far this weekend. It is time for the main event. Four laps of the Max Eicher Arena here in INZELL to decide the destiny of the 2023 FIM Ice Speedway World Championship. Svensson, Harahiltunen, Zorn and Simon underway for the grand final. Good start by Zorn. He goes into the lead on the first turn. Not the best of getaways for Harahiltunen. He's in second place. Frankie Zorn leads it. Simon comes through in the third ahead of Svensson. But if he stays in second, Martin Harahiltunen, he will have done enough to win the title. He doesn't want to win it with second, though. He wants a double maximum for the weekend. He goes for the inside into turns one and two on Frankie Zorn. They're side by side. Harahiltunen leads coming out of turn two. Is it going to be 12 wins out of 12 for the Swede here this weekend? Now starting to pull away from Frankie Zorn. Simon in third.
A risk that Harahiltunen really didn't need to take. Second position would have been enough to take the world title, but he's fought his way through to the front, and now he's got clear air, and it is Frankie Zorn settling in now for second position. This would move him on to 32 world championship points. It would be the same score for Harold Simon if he remains in third, so he could have a runoff to decide the silver and bronze medals in 2023.
And there's no doubt about who's going to win the gold. He comes down into the final turn. Up the home straight, Martin Harahiltunen is world champion for the second year running. For the first time ever, two non-Russian winners in a row. The Swede has retained it. Zorn came over in second, Simon is third. Niklas Svensson out the back, looks like some damage to his machine, slowing him in the closing stages there. But Martin Harahiltunen, the Swede, has won it for the second year running, and he is elated. Congratulations to Martin Harahiltunen. He has dominated this weekend. Donuts on the home straight from Frankie Zorn as well. Always a great entertainer, always a fan favourite. So we have at present a tie for second place. Looks like it is going to be a runoff, as you say, Alex, between the two Austrians for second and third for silver and bronze. Luca Bauer has to be content with fourth place. Niklas Svensson there can qualify for the final. Finished at the back, he will finish fifth overall. He picks up the 14 points.
Ha-ha! Martin Harahiltunen has done it again. Dropped the bike into the bales, and now the celebrations begin for Harahiltunen. We will need to check the rule book on that tie for second in the World Championship, because there is a chance that that's going to be decided on countback on the best of the best finish over the weekend, which would be Frankie Zorn. But we'll wait on confirmation of that. In the meanwhile, it will be Martin Harahiltunen confirmed as world champion. Zorn a medalist once again in 2023. Just going to get Martin to get himself comfortable, and we'll get the first reaction of the 2023 world champion, crowned for the first time, of course, last year. It is four grand.